as already I have discussed from in last three video till question number 30. But in last video I have got some of the suggestions because I had missed in 29, 20, 30 questions video while editing. Why? Because and that time you people have not get the fully explanation of 29 and 30 question of the explanation. So in this video I will try to explain in next 20 minutes from 29 to 40 number of the questions, and make sure each and every question I will give a clear and crystal concept behind the questions and what the examiner are expecting from you and what how to tackle the questions. My dear friend, as you know, your examination is still having the very good amount of the times. So till next 2-3 months no examination will be come. So I will promise you, before the coming any examination of the ISRO, I will finish the all the electronics engineering technical assistant question paper. So don't worry, because you people are always having the anxiety and you are commenting me, sir, please solve all the question and please make the regular video. So I also having the some personal as well as professional commitment, that's why I'm not getting full time. But I am promising you, I will make all the question paper solution and detail explanation before any exam commencing next one month. So don't worry. So before going to the questions and answer, I'll tell you, please subscribe my channel and share with your friend and like, and don't forget to comment below in this video comment box, because your comment is giving me immense satisfaction as well as and to that are motivating to hard work for you, to do the hard work for you. Okay, so please share this video among your all the junior, senior friends, colleagues, whoever having in electronics engineering and instrumentation and control engineering also, so they can also benefit it from my video and they can also clear the examination and they can also get the good concepts. Okay, so let's go with question number 29. As you know, question number 29 is, as you are seeing on a screen, the question number 29 is the BCD 001001001 is the equivalent to binary equivalent. Means, my dear friend, they have given a BCD code 001001001. As you know, BCD means binary coded decimal, that is also called as 8421 code, and this is a very easier code for computer. Computer system are always working in BCD code only, because they having very easier, and while handling the large amount of the data, they are have the easier in this code only. So computer handling number in BCD code only, because so many group of the 4-digit number they having, so the computer feel very easy to process and handle data in 8421 code in BCD code. And each BCD code are written and represent in 4 bits codes from 0 to 9, and after that each digit, just simply what you are having in decimal number, just convert into write into 4 bit of the your what we call binary number. So it represent as in this BCD code. So as for your understanding, I am going to write here what is the BCD code. As I told, in decimal number, if suppose you write 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10, okay, so if we going to write in BCD code, I want to say you how the BCD are working and representing in from decimal to BCD number. So I told you all the number are represented in a bit, a combination of 4 bits. So 0000 for 0, 001 for 1, 0010, 0011, 0100, 0101, 010, 011, and then 100 and 101. Now it's till you got till 9. What when you go for writing for 10, you will not write just like that. As you know what, 10 is like 1 and 0. So you write 0, 0 in separate. For 1, you have to write separate 4 digits. So this 10, so 11, you will write 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. For 12, you will write 0, 0, 1, 0. For 13, you will write 0, 0, 1, 1. Then 14, you will write 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Then 15, you will write 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is the type of a binary coded decimal number which are always written in four you can tell the 4 bits. So while you having any means any decimal number like 3 and 6, so if you want to convert in a binary number, just change write it into a binary format of 4 bits. So like 6, you can write 6 like that, 0 0 1 1 0, and 3 can write 0 0 1 1. So it converted into BCD number. If any number you write like 2 4, this is a decimal number. If you want to write in a binary number, so just you write 4 bits of binary equivalent. So 4, you can write 0 1 0, and 2 0 1 0. So this become a BCD of the any decimal number. Now you having the question with you, a BCD format is a 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0 1 0. This is the your BCD format of any decimal number. It may be, just I told, any decimal number can directly write to the 4 bit of a binary number, so that becomes a separate, so that's become a BCD code. Now just you do the reverse process. All the 4 bit of a binary number you just convert into a decimal number. So 0110 is a 6, and 0010 is a 2, and 001 is a 1. So this become, this number I am writing here becomes 126. So this BCD equivalent of binary number is 126. Okay, you got. So now you got a decimal number. Now as per question you are getting, we have to convert into binary number. So now just as you know, you convert with binary number, just you as you know how to convert decimal number to binary number, we just divide and you see the what is the remainder, then we'll get the binary number. So just divide here. Sorry, 1 here, 7, 14, 1, 1, 1. So, like that, you have converted this BCD into decimal and decimal into binary. So, you can write the binary equivalent and 0. So, this is your binary equivalent of this BCD number. Any doubt? So now I got 111 1110. Where is the option 111 110? So option A is a binary equivalent of this BCD number. Okay, so now you 29 question you got. Any BCD number, if any decimal number they have given, you just write equivalent of their binary number in 4 bits, it become BCD code, BCD number. Then if you want to convert into binary number, just convert this separate 4 bit into decimal number. Now you get that decimal number, just you convert into binary number, you will get the binary equivalent of BCD number. Okay, so 29 option 8 came already came. Now 30 number each question is, the minimum distance required for a code to detect and correct single bit error each. Okay, the question is directly from digital communication. You can tell the digital communication topics where our Hamming code is a topic. From there we are using error detecting as well correcting. So what they are telling, what is the minimum distance required for a code to detect and correct the single bit error. So you go and study in digital communication topic or data communication topics, error detection code and Hamming code. So this they are telling a single bit error, single bit error. Suppose I will tell bit, a single bit equal to bit is k is equal to 1. Okay, as a for detecting a error and correcting error, Hamming code required. And Hamming coding is a technique. Suppose I having a m bit of data string, okay, and m bit of data string, suppose I having 1 1 1 1 0, like that a data string. I want to modulate and transfer into some another positions, then after the demodulation I will get the same data. Now before sending data, I know this is the 1 2 3 4 number of 1 and 1 number of 0. But in any case, suppose any noise or any things happen in between transmissions, some of the data bit becomes 0 or 1, okay? So that will not a same data which we are sending to receiver's side. So how that receiver will know this data which have came to that side is correct or not correct? So in general term, we are sending the any envelope or any postcard. On there we are writing the address with house number and pin number only. So in Hamming code, think like that only. This data will send with a additional data, means we are adding some of data. Suppose 1 2 3 4 1 is there, I will add one more 2 4 2 2 1 I added. So how much becomes 1 4 6 6 total, one we have in a total string of the data with added this data. So this added, whatever we are adding to correct there and detect their error is not there, because now I will add one more 2 data, so I will know total 6 we are going to send, 1 0 going to send. So now total 6 1 is there. If one there, one parity checker is there, that parity checker they will change, that is even parity or odd parity, you might have heard during digital communication topic. So suppose this is 6 bit, they will add 1. So 6 plus 1, 7. So already 6 bit here means even bit, then 1 they will add there, they will got odd parity. If suppose you are 5, here already 5, if suppose 5 data total 1 bit, then they will add one more there, it equals 6. It become even parity. So like that they are checking the data, the same data is come or not. So that are doing by Hamming code. So while sending there, I having the m bit of the data string, and suppose I send this parity bit r bit with them. So the Hamming code relation is there, so that total number of bits should be greater than equal to m plus r plus 1. That is the relation. This much should be this m plus r plus 1 with total parity. One is parity and even parity they are sending, they are checking. So this much data should be data which we are going to transmit any transmission lines at any communications. So that should be equal to 2 to power r, greater than 2 to power r, equal to 1. So this data is there. So due to this technique, they are correcting as well as detecting the error. Okay, now you think, my friends, now I have sent already, now each and every data is there, suppose m bit of data is there. So each and every data, some minimum distance required between all the data. So the Hamming distance is minimum required for correct n number of data, a k number of the data, that should always equal to 2k plus 1 Hamming distance. So suppose k bit error is there, k bit error is there, then you have to minimum Hamming distance 2 into, if suppose according to question 1 bit error is there, k is 1 plus 1, means 3 Hamming distance minimum required for correct and detect a single bit of the error. And Hamming distance in always written like that, D A and B, where A is data string and B is your the Hamming distance, minimum distance, like that, of your redundant bit. So a code if having the k bit error, so that minimum having distance between any two of its code, two code we are, if you are sending, suppose any code, first code they have sent and then second code they have sent, they should always having some of the differences. So as you know, like unit distance code is a gray code like that, so they also always having a difference between the one bit distance. So for detecting and correcting between the two data, Hamming code should have always 2k plus 1 bit of distance. So here your as per question, the minimum Hamming distance, minimum distance required for code to detect and correct a single bit error is 2 plus k is a single bit plus 1, means 3 distance minimum required for correct a single bit error. So questions number 30, option C, 3. So 30 you got the option C. So that's it. These two I have explained, this question 29 and 30. So I think I have clear your all the doubt. If any doubt you having in Hamming code and binary coded decimal code, my dear friend, then please go to digital electronics topic, binary coded decimal, and digital communication or at data communication topic, Hamming code. So you will get another clear concept, because these two topic always asking the question from any of the examination. In any examination they will ask from this topic. So that's it in this video. In next video I am going to explain the from 30 to 40. Okay.